So in the last video, we examined the notion of validity. Later in the semester, we will learn some formal tools to decide whether an argument is valid or not. But in this video, we'll discuss a more intuitive way of judging an argument's validity, specifically by thinking of counterexamples. So recall that a valid argument is one in which, if the premises are true, the conclusion must be true. Validity pertains to the quality of the reasoning involved in an argument and ignores the question of whether the premises are in fact true. So when judging validity, we simply assume the premises are true and ask ourselves whether the conclusion really follows from those premises while ignoring all of our real-world knowledge. This means that an argument is invalid if it's possible for the premises to be true and the conclusion false. So that means that if we can even imagine a scenario in which the premises are true and the conclusion is false, the argument can't be valid. So that gives us one way to show that an argument is not valid. In particular, we'll say that a counterexample to an argument is a hypothetical situation in which all the premises are true and the conclusion is false. So it's kind of like a little story or a picture that portrays all the premises are true but the conclusion false. And if you can even think of one counterexample to an argument, then you know that it's invalid, since you've shown that it's possible or conceivable for the premises to be true while the conclusion is false. Now, it's important to note that coming up with a counterexample is a kind of proof that an argument is invalid. But if you can't come up with a counterexample to a given argument, that doesn't necessarily mean that the argument is valid. Coming up with counterexamples requires some creative thinking or use of your imagination, and if you're unable to find a counterexample, it could always be the case that one exists, but you just haven't thought of it yet. So counterexamples are really more useful for proving that an argument is invalid. Okay, so let's get some practice with this concept by looking at some basic examples. So take a look at the following argument and see if you can come up with a counterexample. All dogs are fluffy. Fido is fluffy. Therefore, Fido is a dog. Is this argument valid? Is it possible for 1 and 2 to be true, but 3 false? Well, what about if Fido is a fluffy cat? We could easily imagine a world in which all dogs are fluffy, and something called Fido is fluffy, but that thing Fido is not a dog. Fido might simply be a cat. So although this is a really simple example, you can see that this little description of a state of affairs in which all dogs are fluffy, and Fido's fluffy, but Fido is a cat, and therefore not a dog, that shows that the argument isn't valid because the conclusion isn't necessarily true given all of the premises. So that's all we mean by a counterexample, a description of a state of affairs in which the premises are true and the conclusion is false. Okay, so let's think about another example here. Alice is smarter than Bob. Bob is smarter than Carol and Dave. Therefore, Alice is smarter than Dave. So, can you think of a counterexample for this argument? Well, I don't think I can. No matter how much of my imagination I use, I can't seem to think of any possible way that 1 and 2 could be true, but 3 false. So again, this doesn't totally prove that such a scenario is impossible, but it gives me pretty strong reason to think that the argument is valid, since it doesn't seem possible to come up with a counterexample. All right, how about this one? If Alice goes to work, she will either take the bus or ride her bicycle. Alice is going to work, so she'll ride her bicycle. So does this argument have any counterexamples? Well, let's suppose that if Alice goes to work, she'll either go by bus or by bicycle, and let's suppose she does go to work. Does it follow then that she rides her bike? No, it's consistent with 1 and 2 that Alice takes the bus to work. So, a scenario in which Alice takes the bus to work would constitute a counterexample to this argument. Here's a similar argument. If Alice takes the bus to work, she'll be late. Alice does not take the bus to work, so Alice is early. Once again, we can show that this argument is invalid. Just because Alice does not take the bus to work doesn't mean that she gets there on time. Maybe it's a beautiful day and she decides to walk. Or maybe she just decides to stay home. There's a lot of counterexamples to this argument, so it's clearly not valid, even though it might look a little bit similar to some valid arguments that we have seen. All right, let's look at one more example for practice. Every human being has been to the moon. The moon is a star. Therefore, every human being has been to a star. Can you think of a counterexample to this argument? Remember, just because the premises are obviously false in reality doesn't matter. You just have to assume that they're correct and then try to falsify the conclusion. So in this case, it doesn't seem possible to come up with a counterexample. So that suggests that the argument is probably valid. One thing that's important to mention is that when you're coming up with counterexamples, you should let your imagination roam free, but you know, don't cheat. So what do I mean by cheating? Well, consider this argument. If Dave forgets his umbrella, he'll get wet. Dave did forget his umbrella, so Dave will get wet. Now, someone might try to say, hey, what if Dave in sentences 1 and 2 refers to David Letterman, and Dave in sentence 3 refers to David Duchovny? Aha, so the argument isn't valid. Right, that doesn't really constitute a counterexample, since it's really kind of misrepresenting the language in the argument. It's kind of more of a trick, really. Right, so with counterexamples, you can imagine just about anything to be the case, but don't try to play around with the language. You should just assume that sentences have the meanings that they're obviously intended to have. So in this video, we introduced the notion of a counterexample, which is an intuitive way to show that an argument is invalid. It's not a perfectly rigorous method, as you can tell, but it's very intuitive and useful when thinking about arguments.